Musically speaking, June Stomp was one of the best we've had. Nashville's Holy Mountaintop Removers were up first, and after their set, I proclaimed them one of my favorite new bands. The trio consists of a guitarist, drummer, and multi-instrumentalist, who plays bass, keys, and trombone. They perform cinematic instrumentals with surfy overtones. There are elements of avant-garde improvisation, without there being too much dissonance. Holy Mountaintop Removers offer a refreshing take on the genre, and show new and innovative avenues surf music can explore. Display a lot of energy, and are an exciting group in many ways. The members are all young guys, which brings a great deal of enthusiasm and quite possibly some newer influences to the table. Maybe more so than those that have been around in the genre for a while. Don't get me wrong though, these guys know their stuff and definitely have the chops. Now usually I find the mask gimmick played out, but Seahorse uses them to high comedic effect, and it really does add quite a bit to their show. House and the Wow topped off the night with their no-frills rock and roll. Their music is hook-laden and loud, giving credence to the term power pop. Kenny and the gang beguiled us with songs spanning his 20-plus year career, as well as a few choice covers like The Hollies' Carrie Ann, and even an instrumental, The Beatles' Cry for a Shadow, which they learned specifically for the stomp. I should also mention the pools of drool left over from the Seahorse Boys upon viewing Kenny's Rickenbacker guitars and Lee's 50s gold-top Les Paul.